I'm Joseph Dominic. And if you ever thought about making a difference in a kid's life, come on in and let me show you how.
If you have a desire to work with at-risk kids or a passion for helping make a difference in the lives of others, this is the job for you.
First of all, I'm Senator Patrick McMath. I represent the 11th Senate District that runs from Lacombe, includes Mandeville, Covington, where I reside, Madisonville, into Tangipahoa, Robert, all the way. There's a kind of almost runs down the interstate and touches just east of this area where we are now, and stops just short of Ponchatoula. So I have a fair amount of Tangipahoa in my district, and I'd be remiss to not congratulate Ponchatoula and A-Meet Women's Basketball on their championship. I don't know if you guys handled that one yet or not. There you go. Unfortunately, after redistricting, and I know this has probably been talked about, but just I want to real quick speak on the 11th district. I had the largest Senate district by population in the state. I needed to dramatically downsize. I think I had to lose about 38,000 people, which was it's a lot. And unfortunately, the new district does not encompass Tangipahoa Parish, which is a shame because I did really well over here, and I have a significant amount of ties. You know, my sister went to the Southeastern with a number of friends and folks that live in this area. But the good news is, you know, we don't really think just within our bounds in our districts. I think I can speak for all of us when I say that. Especially in this area, on the North Shore, the Florida parishes, in a greater aspect, we at least in the Senate, and I think I can speak for the House as well. We take a regional approach to things. We're a pretty tight knit group. We've gotten a lot stronger just recently, and I'm including Tangipahoa, St. Tammany, and Washington really in that core group. Everybody here represents those parishes. It's a very good thing that we are getting another Senate district. It's another voice, it's another advocate for this area, and it just makes us that much stronger. I can promise you the folks in Shreveport wish they weren't losing one. So their loss is selfishly, it's our gain, and I think that's an exciting thing for this area. I view the North Shore as an emerging leader in the state. We are arguably the second or third most important region, and that's we're rapidly climbing up the list. And what I mean by that is this is where all the growth is. This is where the people want to be. The jobs are coming here. We're kind of turning into the white collar headquarters for the Southeast region. At least in my neck of the woods, we have a number of corporate headquarters, corporate offices. And that's exciting to see, and the growth is a good thing. And if I'm putting on my construction and development background hat right now, if I'm betting on a parish in the next 20 years, it's going to be Tangipahoa Parish, just given the two interstates that intersect here and everything that you guys have going on Southeastern, all of the warehousing, it's exciting stuff. You know, I think we can help support you guys on the school district side. There's the sky's the limit. So kudos to you guys for being a part of really one of the more exciting parishes over the next 20, 30 years. And listen, with that economic growth and development, we have to have the infrastructure to support that growth. And for the first time in a very long time, I think you're starting to see folks that are in this delegation that are in positions to make an immediate and positive impact over the next, 10, 20 years. I think I got 10 years left, assuming I have the opportunity to be reelected, and maybe we might extend those term limits. I'm not entirely sure if that's going to happen or not, but that's for a different subject matter. But I chair Senate Transportation. I worked hard to kind of finagle my way into that position because this is the greatest need in this area. St. Tammany Parish, everybody's sick and tired of sitting in traffic all day, and I know that it's just moving west. So we need to have the infrastructure to support the economic leadership that this area will see again over the next 20 years. And speaking on specific projects, Firetower Road, on my way here, I had a conversation with Larry Sharp, who is the director of this district's DOTD, and we were talking about that interchange. And he explained to me where we were in the process, and we're probably about a year and a half out, and then before it can, the permitting is complete. And then he tacked on another 8 years. I said, whoa, how did you get to, why did we just add another 10 years to this project? And he said, well, funding is an issue. Well, I can tell you, we're going to prioritize projects like that for Tangipahoa and for the North Shore to make sure that we get to skip the line. Because I've been to, we all, those of us that are on the transportation committees, we go on what's called the road show every year. And it tours the 9 DOTD districts across the state, from Winsboro to Monroe, Shreveport, Pineville, down to all the southeast and, or southwest and central regions. And I've never been to Winsboro before. I don't know if anybody else here has. I never really had an opportunity to or need to go to Winsboro, but no one lives there, and they have a 4-lane state highway, and no cars are on it. And you come home and you sit in traffic on the interstate. And 21 and 22, and that's because the folks that were in power back then were from Winsboro. And so it does matter who is in leadership and who is in the chairs of the certain committees that can steer these funding and these projects. So we're getting there. So just want to let you guys know that help is on the way. As far as bills go, and I'll be quick, it's a tradition in the Senate to not be as long-winded as members in the House.
You're so right.
I've got a number of DOTD reform bills. They're more of like a come see me bills to get their attention to, it's sort of playing some chess there, but we're in an interesting time right now. You know, Governor Edwards has 2 years left. Secretary Wilson, his foot's out the door looking for another job, and may not be as inclined to fight some of the reforms that have been attempted in the past. You know, DOTD is a very large bureaucracy, and it just takes way too long to get projects completed, engineered, and funded, and all the things. And so I think there's a number of reasons for that, and I'm going to try to address those in some of the legislation that I'm going to bring this session as chair of Senate Transportation. I know about 6 days ago there was a bus driver sick out in Tangipahoa Parish. We're experiencing the same issues in St. Tammany. I have a bill that is looking to address those concerns. These guys need some help with some funding that hasn't been increased since the 1980s, and so that's something I'm hopeful we can get past. Representative Freeman mentioned a vaccine-related bill that I have. I have two, but Senate Bill 1 is something that I hear. It stemmed from input that I hear every day from our constituents, and the short version of it is a constitutional amendment to add vaccination status to the protected class regarding discrimination. It's going to be an interesting debate that we're going to have. I'm looking forward to that debate. And this stems from the past 18 months, 2 years now, I guess, that we have been dealing with the fallout and the response to COVID. And I have a number of very motivated and frustrated mothers in my district. And this bill stems from their input. So again, I'm looking forward to having that discussion. And finally, I have to address this, Representative Carter, who is very passionate, apparently, about reducing insurance rates, which is fantastic. Louisiana has some of the highest insurance rates in the country. I disagree. I think there is another approach that we can implement in addition to the dash cams, and that is a hands-free legislation to make our drivers better drivers and our safer roads. Because if you reduce the rate of accidents on the roads, you're going to reduce the insurance premiums. It is that simple. And there's been a number of states that have introduced and passed legislation regarding hands-free driving, and they have not only reduced their insurance premiums, they've they've reduced the rates of fatalities. So I'm not bringing that bill this session, but I am co-authoring it with Representative Huval. It is the same bill that Representative Carter voted against.
Injuries can occur anytime, anyplace, and it may not be your fault. I'm Attorney Sherman Madden. It's my duty to make sure you get the legal representation that you deserve. At the Mack Law Firm, we represent you and your family, and we'll make sure your legal needs are met. Contact us at tangilawteam.com. Our team is ready to help.